but it has been a busy day keeping Indian media on its toes, really, with what really has been happening with the border. But there's plenty happening, really, in the commodities, other asset classes as well. I want to really bring your attention to the sugar prices, where we have seen gains in the last few days. The sugar stocks in the last few sessions also have been on the positive side. And this comes in on the back of Brazil putting out that their ethanol output is going to be much higher this time around. And that would cost sugar, really, because that output seems down by 22%. Also, there have been various report suggesting that the world sugar surplus for 2019, supplies rather, for 2019-20 are estimated at a deficit of 1.36 million tons. This, of course, turns around from a surplus that we saw in the last year at around 2.64 million tons. And when you look at the year 2017-18, the surplus at this time, at that time, was estimated at 19 million tons. So clearly, after 2 years of surplus, a third year is seen as a deficit. It's usually how it works in the sugar cycle. In any case, in the meanwhile, the markets are anticipating that the deficit will be seen because of lower crop in India, Pakistan and Thailand. It has been dry weather in many of these countries, and that could really impact the sugar crop going forward. And of course, there's plenty action in the crude oil prices also, where after 3% decline yesterday, we saw prices gain up back yet again, trading nearly half to 1 percentage point higher in the European session right now. What is the sense of the global markets on that, and how do you put strategies there? For that, let's get on board Pritam Kumar Patnaik of Reliance Commodities, who now joins us on the show. Pritam, hi, good to have you. Starting with crude first, and how are you reading it? Because after that very sharp decline, we've seen buying come back quite quickly, 1.25% up for the NYMEX crude prices, almost a percentage point back up for the Brent.
You know, Manisha, you're absolutely right. In addition to doing technical and fundamental analysis, now we've started doing Twitter analysis too. The tweet from President Trump kind of put the pressure on the crude oil prices, and we saw crude correcting almost 3%. But obviously, what comes back to commodity is that the factors of supply and demand. Eventually, the prices bounce back because, you know, OPEC kind of disregarded the entire communication which was put out by President Trump. They continue to maintain this strategy of cutting down their production and maintaining the target of 9.8 million barrel cut in production. They further went ahead to say that they will extend these cuts well into the next year, which is a very significant factor. Given these factors, the supply pressure remains in the crude oil market. To add to that, the API data which came out a few days back kind of suggested, this is for the period of February 22nd, suggested that the inventory buildup could be as high as 4.2 million barrels, which is take the total inventory to 444.3 million barrels. So these two things actually brought the pressure on the crude oil, gave support to the crude oil prices, and that's why we saw the prices bouncing back. But let me put one thing into perspective, Manisha. I don't see this rally going, you know, unabated. I mean, this is going to soften at one particular point of time, and I think it's come to that level. So we aren't bullish at this point because we feel that it's going to move in a broad range, and current range suggests, and it's a good strategy to actually go short at these current levels. So for in-house, we have a call where we're saying we want to go short at 4,000, 4,030 level with a stop loss at 4,070 odd levels and target price of 3,820.
Of course, the crude oil prices do continue to impact the ethanol prices, sugar prices, rubber prices, just to name a few. And the volatility in all of these commodities also has been quite high. But Pritam, with the ongoing, markets were reacting to the Powell statement yesterday, the U.S.-China trade talks, that has been ongoing for some time now. With all of that as a background, how have you seen the metal prices?
Oh, yeah, metal prices had a great week last week. I mean, and we've saw all majority of the metals actually rallying quite a lot. They have kind of stabilized right now and taking a kind of a breather, if you ask me. In the absence of any new data coming in, I think the rally is more or less kind of happened to some extent. I'm not saying that there won't be further rally for this week. If I were to consider this week, we will be a little guarded because then we'll wait for any new development happening on the trade discussion point of view. Okay, and the other bit is obviously we'll have to see what Mr. Powell states today, because you know the way the metals have moved, there's been an impact of the dollar pricing also. So if he comes at something which makes the dollar weaker, they could see some reaction on the metal prices. But in the absence of this, I feel that the any significant news that will come on the metal side of it will only come in the corresponding weeks. So in this week, I think given the kind of rally that the metal prices have seen, we would be selling copper at anything which is below 458 with a stop loss of 462 and a target price of 451.
And a quick word on the precious metal prices before we let you go. How have you seen the gold prices? We now seem to be trading in a very, very narrow range after that huge run-up that we've seen in the first 1.5 months of
Correct. So, Manisha, you're absolutely right. You know, gold itself has, again, despite the fact that the dollar had weakened post the confirmation of the dovish stance by the U.S. Fed, you know, which has said that it will only react to data which comes out, and that is fairly conservative view, and everybody has a view that the dovish stance is going to be maintained. Given that fact, and then the absence of any major event expected in this week, I think gold has run its rally for some time, and it will also, you know, consolidate at these prices. In our view, we would be tempted to give a sell call at this moment, but we think it's better to wait out and watch, and only take a strategy next week, because then you'll get a clear direction in the market.
Fair point that. And we've noted all of that down. Thank you so much, Pritam, for making time and giving us strategies on all of those sectors like energy, precious metals, and of course, metals as well. Before we wrap, those are the flashes on the bottom of your screen from the Pakistan PM as well coming in, where he says that the Indian pilots are actually in their custody and they do not want any terrorists to be on their ground there. But today's action is to show intent and that they have offered full cooperation to India are some of those flashes coming on the screens right now. But with that, that's all the time that we have on this edition of Closing Bell. All the action now on After the Bell.